The twin-seat A-1E models that the Air Force had first taken out of Navy mothballs simply wore out. There comes a time in the life of an aircraft when the next rebuild cannot be justified, and the E models had come to that point. The U.S. Air Force would continue to use Skyraiders, replacing the aging E's with the single-seat H model. The last E model flew its final mission on the 10th of April, 1967, and was hoisted aboard ship for its journey back to the USA. There was quite a bit of history in that moment. The nickname Spad referred to a First World War biplane. At first, it expressed the scorn of the jet pilots for the lumbering old war horses that cluttered their airfields. However, the Spads in Vietnam changed that scorn into grudging respect, and then into awe. In time, many of the jet jockeys would owe a great deal to the Spads, because Vietnam had given the Skyraiders a new task. Many knowledgeable people maintain that the Spads found their finest hour in this new role. Rescue helicopter escort. The rescue parties involved a variety of aircraft, control aircraft, spotters, the rescue choppers, and the pugnacious A-1s as escorts. The control aircraft would patrol at height, listening for the radio beacon of a downed pilot. After establishing the pilot's whereabouts, a rescue team would be directed to the area. Strike aircraft would also be involved in covering the operation, especially when the rescue was conducted deep inside North Vietnam. The work of these crews, in the helicopters and the other aircraft, required great courage. Despite the danger, the units pressed each mission as hard as possible, and in the course of the war, were credited with an amazing 3,833 rescues. Skyraiders filled the role of escort well. They had the endurance to stay aloft for hours. They could quite happily hover along with the slow helicopters. At the location of a rescue, they could bring their firepower into play to suppress any hostile activity in the area, allowing the Jolly Greens to go about their business with little interference. For these missions, the Skyraiders were fully loaded with ordnance and ammunition. Because of the vulnerability of the helicopters to ground fire, it was essential that enemy activity be suppressed before the choppers presented themselves as stationary targets hovering above the downed crew. As a result, the A-1s would engage in what was referred to as trolling for fire. This consisted of flying low and deliberately drawing fire from enemy guns near the scene. When these guns had been located and silenced, the air would be safer for helicopters. It did, however, make a Skyraider a dangerous place to be. The rescue team's motto was, that others may live. To that end, they were prepared to risk their lives. The parajumpers, the men who went down the wire to the pilot, were trained scuba divers in case the rescue took place over water. They were qualified parachutists and experts with small arms and hand-to-hand combat. They were also fully trained in first aid. With the rest of the crew, they faced the danger of flying low and slow in their chopper to the rescue site, often under intense fire. Then they left even the aircraft's limited safety to become dangling targets. That others may live.